In this video, we will take a look at route planning with GaiaGPS so that we can plan for our next off-road or ATV trip. Here on the map in GaiaGPS, I'm doing this on my iPad. You can see the blue track here on the map. These are tracks that I've done recently with my side-by-side, but this area has many, many other trails, and I'm not sure which ones are suitable for the side-by-side or too technical or still valid. So what I want to do here is start planning out some routes using GaiaGPS so that I can export those routes to my Garmin GPS for the next time I'm passing by and may want to explore. So by starting to tap on the top right, this will reveal map sources. In GaiaGPS, you have access to many types of different digital maps. Now, you can add more maps here by tapping on Add New Map Layer, and you can see the list of maps we have available. We also have a filtered list here at the top based on our activity. So what we're going to do here is we're just going to tap on Overlanding. It can kind of give you like the best of. Now, since most of these maps displayed here is based in the US, I'm in Canada, so I need to exit out of this and go back to map layers and scroll down, and you can see that we have a bunch of map sources for Canada, Europe, and what have you here. The first two map layers are free maps, so if you're a basic GaiaGPS user, you can use those, but if you're a premium user, you have access to all these other map layers. So there are a couple ones that I've been adding and that I use, which is the Backroad Mapbooks Maps, which is a map provider here in Canada, and I've been using their products for a little while, so I tend to like it. So there's three or four that I've extracted here. So for the purpose of this video here, we'll use the top three, which is ATV trails, Canada trails, which is like hiking trails, and snowmobile trails. So in order to make a map source visible, all I have to do is tap on the green icon and bring it up to the top, and this will load up the map. So you can see here with the Mapbooks Canada, around my blue track, I do see some dirt roads that are kind of visible, but I want to see if there's maybe a little bit more detailed information in terms of ATV or off-road type of trail. So I'm going to load up another map layer here. I'm going to load up here the snowmobile trails, and you can see here now I'm starting to see some pink lines, and some of these routes are visible. I'm just going to turn down the transparency for some of these layers so we can actually see the snowmobile trails layer a little bit better. And some of these trails are actually real. I've checked some of the local clubs here. So I'm going to activate now the Canada trails, which is more hiking kind of trails or off-road trails, which is now the orange. These are valid too because some of these are rails to trails, access roads, a little bit of hiking trails, connector trails, that kind of stuff. And the last one here I'm gonna turn on here, which is going to be the ATV trails. These are more quad ATV. They may be a little bit more technical. They may be part of a club. You can see now you have these orange tracks that are now appearing. So you can see around my blue loop track that I've done, there's a whole bunch of new areas for me to explore. So let's zoom in here on the track I did a little while ago. You can see here in the middle, have gone halfway through one of these orange trails, took a picture. And what I wanted to show you here is that sometimes you're not quite sure if the trail is passable, if it's more muddy or not. But here's a picture of this spot before I turned around. Lots of water, lots of mud. We're in early spring, so it's not quite the trail that I wanted to go down at this time by myself. So this is why I wanted to do some route planning, to be able to see which trails are more passable, more accessible, or is still valid. So it could be that some of this map information might not be correct. So I will now use another map source, which is one on the satellite imagery levels here. So there's a whole bunch to choose from. The one that works best for me in my region here is just the satellite provided by Mapbox. And you can see now that we have this satellite layer enabled. I'm just going to turn down the transparency here on a couple of these other map layers here so I can take a look and zoom in a little bit tighter here. And now you can see from one of my previous tracks here, let me just turn down the transparency. You can see now from the satellite the condition of the road. And since I've already traveled some of this road, I can tell from the satellite that this is a suitable side-by-side friendly trail. In fact, motorcycle, trail cycles, off-road vehicles can go up this road. So now it's pretty easy to plan. I can see there's a couple wooded areas, but at least I can still see the road. Unlike the path that I gone down and turned around halfway through, you can see here from the satellite imagery that it's partially wood covered. You can also see a little swampy, boggy area here down at the bottom. So a little further evidence that it might be a little wet going here. Although there seems to be a better road if I were to use an alternate route here. So this is kind of why you want to use the satellite imagery to kind of validate where you might be passing based on what the type of trail you want to do. You may like to use the muddy route, but for my first trips here in this area, I want to stick to better conditioned roads here. So one of the things you can do is try to validate if this trail is actually valid. So one good way you can do that is to add an overlay, which here in GaiaGPS is via the public track. So all the information or tracks that people upload to GaiaGPS, and if they want to make it public, it will be visible on the map. So what I'm going to do here is turn on the slider for public tracks. So now hopefully I will see if this section of trail is used. So let me turn down the transparency a little bit, and I should see green overlays over these tracks. So let me just zoom out here. I don't see any. I don't know if you can see here on the map, there's some light green trails here. You kind of sort of see it here on the right. So let me see, let me zoom out here. And here we go. You can see these green tracks here at the very top here of my blue. And if I were to tap on those tracks, you can see all the public tracks that people have made available in GaiaGPS. So you can actually use these tracks for your planning, but at least I can validate now, and with the overlay tracks, which are the more popular ones, the darker green the track, the more people have been uploading. So you can see that this particular areas here are a little bit more well traveled. So this is great for planning. It kind of gives you that validation here. So what we're going to do here is going to turn on the transparency of the ATV trails, because there was a crossing here I want to show. And if I were to zoom in a little bit here on the map, it kind of shows a crossing here, but you can see very two faint tracks on each side that kind of went back and forth and didn't actually attempt. So this is a good sign that even though the map says that you can cross there, it's probably not wise, depending since nobody has made this track available and there was two different attempts on each side and it wasn't done. So maybe this is a path we want to avoid. So now we're ready to actually start creating our route. So what I'm going to do here is start from one of my last tracks here, and I'm going to tap on the little plus and I'm going to create a route. And here's my little blue dot to start the route. So I'm going to tap and hold and just bring it down here to the end of the track. I'm just going to zoom in. I'm going to tap and hold and put it more on the road. And from the bottom left, you can see I'm in driving mode. You can change the mode here from hiking, cycling, or straight line. But I'm going to choose driving. And based on your map layer, the route will snap to the road. So what I'm going to do is just pick a point and it automatically snaps. And here I'm just going to scroll up and build my route that way. So I'm just going to go in and tap and go up. And you can see here at the bottom of the screen, you can see the elevation profile. You can see down at the bottom right the distance. You can see the elevation. And I'm just going to start building my route like this, and try to get to my other blue loop here across this rather large lake. And we are almost done here. We're gonna tap or insert our last route point here, and this will connect to a path that I did the other day. So now I have a 28.8 kilometer route that I can store, and if I'm exploring, I can definitely follow this route now that I've done my research and validated that this is an appropriate route or a popular route. So now that is done, we're going to save the route. So we're going to tap on save on the top right. And now we're going to give it a name, and we're going to give it an activity, and we're going to save it. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to replace one of the default addresses because of how I created the route. I'm just going to enter the file name here. And now the file is saved. You can see here we have our information, our summary. So now what we can do here is we can complete it here. I'm going to tap on change color, and I want to change the track to red. So that's easier for me to see what our routes I'm planning. And then the tracks that I've done, I'll save it as blue. So that's kind of how I categorize what I've done and what I want to do. The other thing that you can also do is choose the type of activity for this. So I'm just going to categorize this as an ATV route. And with that, the last thing you can do, you can add some notes or deal with the privacy or make it public. But I want to actually share this and actually export it to my Garmin device. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to tap on export file. And this will give us a couple options to export or file formats. We're going to choose GPX, and we're going to send it to our Garmin Explore app that's installed on our iPad. We can also email it, text it, do a couple of things, but basically here I'm just going to find my Garmin Explore app, and that will allow me to save it in my collections, and then I can sync up to any of my Garmin devices like a GPS 66, my Montana, or the Garmin Tread, which I use for off-road. So now that I hit share, Garmin Explore opened up and imported the file. And now what I can do here is I can scroll over, and I'm going to tap on the loop. Now I know what it is, so I'm going to tap on it, and you can see here that here is my saved route now imported into Garmin Explore. And I can tap on it. Now I'm going to tap on the three dots on the top right. So I'm going to change the color to bright red to kind of match my color scheme here for planned routes. And also I'm going to tap on the collections here. And when you're using Garmin Explore, you can categorize all your activities in different folders or collections or libraries. When I am using my Garmin Tread, I am only syncing activities that I use on that device. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to activate Garmin Tread or move this route to Garmin Tread. And if I wanted to make it visible on my other Garmin devices next time I sync with that device, I'll be able to see that detail. But for right now, I'm just going to leave it on for the Garmin Tread library or collection. And now with that, I'm basically done. All I need to do now is next time I'm on the trail and I want to spark up the Garmin Tread, I'll be able to sync up my Garmin Explore data onto the GPS, and I'm good to go.